Trev, the main developer here and the leader of Path of Exile Mobile, and we're going to be playing this for the first time, myself, and I'm really, really excited because this is my first chance to actually encounter Path of Exile 2 content. The lines are so long here at Exilecon, and what I've seen so far that Trev showed me ahead of time here, I am really excited for. So should we just jump right in?
I think just jump into it, yeah.
Okay, so this is my first time seeing any of this. Although I did get a little bit of a head start from Trev, little tip is I should play either the Marauder or the Sorceress if I want a little bit of an advantage. And as someone who really, really wants to try some Path of Exile 2-related content especially, we're going to be going with the Sorceress. But I will pop up the Marauder because I have questions about melee especially. All right. So Sorceress, Intelligence, and Cast Spells. That's what I like. Okay, what did she was a dangerous political dissident.
Yeah, so we kind of themed each of the characters with that crime, because you actually start off in the Colosseum, and it's all part of like the storyline with Dominus, kind of basically looking for someone to actually do his missions for him.
So, oh, really? Interesting.
Yeah. It's not a beach.
It's not a beach. Yeah, yeah. And can you comment on the relationship between Mobile's story and theming compared to Path of Exile 1 and 2?
Yeah, so Mobile is a prequel, so it's basically set before both Path of Exile 1 and 2, and it's kind of like an origin story kind of theme with Dominus and Valdo, obviously going to shape up there. Mm-hmm. So yeah, it's got a nostalgia factor for existing players, so they're kind of like, yeah, they recognize it, but it's also completely bespoke content for Mobile.
Okay. So. Very cool. All right. And I'm playing Standard League?
Yeah.
All right. So does that mean there's going to be challenge leagues and everything?
Yep. The leagues are planned.
Definitely. Okay.
Yeah.
All right. Excellent.
Yeah. We're keeping exactly the same model. So.
I got to read these tips. All right. All right. Yeah, we're just following the. This is my first time seeing any of that. Following the tutorial. Here we go.
Yeah. I think very much like last time, I'm not going to say much. I just want you to kind of experience it.
Okay.
Freedom must be earned. Choose a weapon and ready yourself.
Get ready for battle. Loot the weapon rack. Okay. Stop that. All right.
Enter the arena.
There's a problem with mobiles, thumbs.
Yeah, yeah.
You must do more than simply survive. You must impress my lord.
Okay. All right, so I move around like this. You have taken damage, tap a
weapon. So this is basically the first tutorial step. Like, we're trialing a lot of the kind of tutorials. Actually, we're using Exilecon to trial it and see what people think. Hmm. But, like, we've actually added, like, moments where we pause the gameplay so you can kind of see like, tutorial tips.
Oh, that's wonderful. Okay. All right. So it looks like, can you comment on the flask system besides this?
The what, sorry?
The flask system.
So flask system is paralleling Path of Exile 2. So, like, you know, you have available flasks. With regards to kind of your health and your flask recovery, you still actually have to visit wells to recover them. Mm-hmm. So each town will have a well in that you actually recover your flask from.
So. Okay, so a little ruthless taste in there, huh?
Yeah,
your
yeah.
Show mouth, criminal. Show the respect.
It's yeah. I guess it's a kind of a subject of contention. Like, yeah. It's, mm-hmm. We're again just experimenting.
Wait. Hold up. This is Dominus.
Yeah.
Okay. All right.
A little bit younger.
All right. He's looking nice. Employ the thaumaturgy within to defeat your enemies. Without its power, you're of little use to me. Virtue gem, huh? I mean, I'm just going to be absorbing as much lore as I can here, because this is all new to me. Okay.
So this is our kind of, yeah, we've worked tirelessly on the menu system, trying to, because obviously the scope of Path of Exile, the amount of like currencies and just the inventory itself, it's been really like a real challenge to actually kind of get all of the content onto a mobile device. So, yeah, what you're seeing here parallels Path of Exile 2 with regards to design, but obviously we've deviated from mobile just so, yeah, so it suits the platform. Mm.
Okay, we're going back in the arena.
Unfortunately, you've died.
Okay. All right, well, we're testing the soft core mechanics right away, seeing how those go. All right, let's get back in there. We kind of resetting this now?
Yes.
The tutorial resets.
Gotcha.
That's why I suggested
play an easier character. Okay, my fault. I got seduced by the sorceress. Okay. I'll just do the regular thing that I do on a regular league start, and we'll just we'll spam pass everything really quickly to catch up.
Okay. Like part of Exile 2, yeah, the dodge, the roll.
Oh, we actually have this dodger. Okay.
Yeah.
All right.
I wasn't gonna tell you. I was like,
you're just gonna let me. You're just gonna let me die, and then
All right,
I see how it is.
My power knows no bounds.
And for our accounts and all of that, is there going to be API connectivity similar to, like, are we going to be able to support stuff with third-party tools just like Path of Exile 1 and 2?
Yeah, I mean, we're trying to kind of introduce new features, like, for example, in the skill tree, we're discussing actually having a template system within the skill tree as a social feature as well to be able to share your builds with your friends. But, again, there's no sort of... Yeah, we're not stopping players from obviously using websites and that to build that. So
I was just going to see if I could boost myself here a little bit in the tutorial. All right, I'm staying behind all these guys first.
Yeah.
All right, and I see it has all of the new Path of Exile 2.
By Path of Exile 2, you've got your default attack, so with the star. So when you run out of mana, that's...
Oh, then we just go to the default fireball that gets equipped. Yep. I see.
But you are about to get a mana flask, so...
Okay, and then on
first
the right...
First steps of the tutorial are really just introducing one step at a time, and then, like, you've got the finale coming up.
Gotcha, okay. I will try very hard not to die this time.
Your final trial. The ordeal ahead will ensure only the strongest survive. But you must be cunning as well. My aid will provide you with what you need.
Nice, okay.
Yeah. Apparently the feed for this is getting a bit stuttery, so we apologize for that, but generally speaking, the game is fine. It's unfortunately just the feed.
Oh, yeah, sorry about that. It feels fine. I can tell you it feels fine in the on the actual phone. Okay. I'm just going to hang out, let these buddies take all the damage.
Should I give you a tip? Like, maybe
I'll take all the tips.
Take the punishment first?
Yeah.
So.
All right. Yeah, if you got any game facts tips, let me know. Oh, and then using my mana flask. Got it. Now, is there like a general kind of auto-targeting for our character here is what I'm facing?
You're basically paralleling the console for targeting.
Mm-hmm.
There is some advanced kind of skill features that are specific for mobile as far as targeting with the touchscreen, but I think that's something we'll talk about at another time.
Okay.
In a bit more detail.
Okay. All right.
Another tip.
Yeah.
It's not over yet. So just be ready.
All right, so I'm going to immediately equip this gear that I got. We're going to take our time, level up, pretend like we're playing hardcore. Must identify items. Okay, got it.
Yeah, so...
Drag on. Oh, there's a vendor who identifies all your items free of charge.
Yeah.
Who
again? That's not a
who pushed that for? I like that.
Yeah,
can we get that everywhere.
Yeah, it's basically so, like, with regards to, like, you know, people interacting with towns a bit more. So
Yeah, no.
Kind of putting more things in town just so you get that level of interaction.
That's a great feature. Okay. And then to equip it, go here. Got it. And all right, I think we're good. And I'm going to use the life flight. You said you warned me. All right.
A powerful display of collaboration. Unfortunately, I only need one of you.
Turns out my buddies are not so good buddies.
Yeah,
so got it.
I want to let them kill each other.
Yeah. I'll just get... I'll just get some loot while they fight each other here a little bit. Oh, man, they hit hard. Oh, shit.
Yeah, kill him. Oh, your health. Your health.
Yeah. You guys like hard games, huh?
Yeah. You should be able to finish him, though.
All right. And all the other ones kill each other. Okay.
All right.
Dama's my new man.
Impressed. I have a special task for you. You may earn your freedom if you survive.
What if I just say goodbye?
It's game over.
Okay. I won't. I'm always tempted to take the troll option. All right. Assign points. All right, cool. Very smart. Very, very smart. Yep. Don't overwhelm people right away.
Yep.
I gotcha. Energy shield.
So, yeah, you have to cancel that one.
Yeah, give me the damage. Yeah. Always damage. We already established this as soft core.
So, for this, just to make sure you do the right thing, it's like tap hold.
Okay, and now?
Yeah, so what you're seeing here is just a demo skill tree. So obviously this isn't final. We've just shown like the starting off trees for each of the characters.
All right, I won't spend that. I want to like look at every single one.
We're not intending to have this final skill tree.
I'm so tempted to look at every single one. My PoE patch notes brain is going wild right now.
I am Dominus, Adjunct Inquisitor of the Templar Order. This laboratory is the workplace of Chief Archon Valdo Caesarius.
And we get Valdo.
Quite
all right.
The most intelligent man in Oriath. Valdo and his benefactor came to this place not long ago. Both went missing soon after. We must discover the truth of what happened here.
Oh, he's so young.
One thing I'm noticing is I think the connection with Apple TV is causing some stuttering.
Is that what's causing the stuttering?
Yeah.
Okay.
Because it's definitely, I thought it would be kind of cleaner than this once you got to here. So I think the Apple TV is a problem, just to be kind of clear.
A strange device in this laboratory.
Oh, this looks very familiar. I know where I am.
Considering that both men disappeared from this building without being seen, I think the implication is obvious.
I have a feeling we're going to be doing maps soon.
I mean,
I've already sent some of my.
It was a logical decision to use the Atlas for mobile, just so you've got that very quick ability to jump in, do a map, and out again. So, very early on, we just thought, we'll use that. You also have the Atlas map, which we use as an inventory as well as a progression map. Mm-hmm. So, it was a very logical decision considering the size of the screen and what you have to work with on mobile. So,
you will have your freedom. His benefactor has some value as well. Keep me apprised. Anything you find.
Select one reward.
There is only one.
Yeah, the new... I noticed that in the card game, the new transmutation art is very appealing. A lot of people on Reddit and Twitter have been raving about it, and they're really excited about it. Very, very cool. Okay, and we got a map device here. We got our well. We have our apothecary. Oh, I'm too poor. All right. Yeah. I see how it is. Okay.
I'll definitely hit the well up before you go any further.
How many times can I die doing this demo? Interesting. Wait, hold on. What are these folks doing here?
Oh, that's all the players upstairs.
Real? Okay.
Yeah.
Oh, so we're actually just on a live server a general chat. Wow, you guys are ballsy. Doing a live demo like this? You guys are real ballsy. All right.
Well, hello there. I can activate this on
a young island. Yeah, this is. I mean, the POE1 nostalgia is already like.
Wherever it goes.
And a throwback to the old Atlas as well. I mean, you're definitely hitting those buttons.
So in Act 1, we want to slowly introduce the mechanics. So
okay.
Act 1, you're literally kind of following orders and you're going on each of these maps. But then, like, in Act 2, then we start introducing you can pick maps up, you find them, and then you can start actually... It's a little bit more kind of sort of dynamic as far as, like, there is a quest path, but you can sort of jump between maps to resolve it, basically. So, and then kind of as we progress even further, like, into sort of beyond Act 3, you can then start actually sort of applying currency in that to your maps as well. So we just slowly introduce it just so people can get familiar with the concepts. Mm-hmm. So.
All right, let's get mapping. All right, who are these guys? There's Dominus.
Veneris.
Yep, that's Veneris. Wow. So I'm just like fawning over the all the lore and the characters.
So all of the content we're using is actually Path of Exile 2 assets.
Mm-hmm.
Obviously, we need to tailor it and like kind of optimize it for mobile.
Mm-hmm.
So that's the process we're constantly going through and still going through at the moment. So, yeah, we want it to look like a AAA game, and I think we're getting there. We're heading that direction. So,
yeah, I mean, I love Path of Exile 1, but like even the mobile version with the POE2 assets, it's pretty striking. Now, is there a way for me to make this mini map? Okay, all right, plus 1 points right there.
So you can actually use that as a joystick, so you can pan around the map.
Oh, wow. Okay.
Yeah, you're in trouble.
Mm. All right, yeah, I'm
unfortunate about the streaming.
3 days ago, I was playing Tornado Shot with the Mage Blood. I gotta recalibrate. Oh, and I got to get into the habit of hitting that well every single time, too, right?
Mm-hmm. So, again, yeah, it's definitely a point of contention. But, you know, we are paralleling and sticking to Path of Exile 2 as close as possible.
Mm-hmm.
The goal was to, you know, zero compromise with regards to the mobile. So, yeah, we want everyone to have the same kind of experience they have on the PC.
And regarding loot and everything on the ground and picking it all up, are there any unique features of that in Path of Exile Mobile, unique challenges with all of that, loot filters, for example?
Loot filters is something that's on the cards. We're obviously trying to solve the problem with regards to the amount of drops. But in general, as far as like usability and like friendly play, like you can actually tap items on the screen that are visible and to pick them up, as well as using the actual action button to pick them up. So you don't actually have to run around to physically pick stuff up. As long as they're in line of sight, there's no obstacles in the way.
All right, more passive points.
Yeah,
And will the loot filters be... a lot of this might not be sorted. I'm already thinking, like, okay, supporting loot filters for the general populace, sharing them with each other. Like, what's the relation there of,
It's still yet to be decided, but yeah. It definitely will be loot filters.
Okay. Neversync? Get on that. Yeah, I already saw that he tweeted, like, oh, Path of Exile 2 and Path of Exile 1 filters, and now Path of Exile Mobile filters. And now we might need Path of Building. We might need three different Path of Buildings now, too. Oh, man. Can I use the potions on the right side as well?
You can, yeah.
The flasks? Okay.
Yeah.
Good, because, yeah, I want to be like...
if you're running.
Yeah, I want to run away and use them. Yeah, yeah.
That's why we opted for the orb as well, so it's that you can switch between the two.
I like that. And
you can actually just adjust the HUD. What I was mentioning before about the kind of advanced skill use is we have a D-pad system, which the skill set you have at the minute is probably not worth actually investigating, but we have a system where it allows you to swipe in the direction on the screen. So you equip them into the D-pad slots, and then it basically means that you've got targetable skills.
Oh, okay.
We opted for that system rather than actually having a press hold and a directional target, primarily just because of the pace of the game for Path of Exile. It's like, yeah, you need very fast response for your skills. So, there's basically a system where you can just swipe on the screen. The reason I'm mentioning that is, like, when you can customize and tailor your HUD, you can actually scale the size of the joystick area as well. So it means you've got larger screen space for doing your targetable skills and stuff like that. So we've made it as customizable as possible. Sorry, I'm distracting you.
I look up for 1 second. I'm almost dead already. Okay. Yeah, I want to talk to this this quest NPC in the middle of my map. What is he doing? Doesn't he know this is Path of Exile? I just want to run stranded and run to the end. What's going on, buddy? All right. What's he got to say?
Our squad was ambushed. I must get word to the Inquisitor. I doubt I'll last much longer out here alone. Help me!
I'd recommend aid.
Did you recommend it? Okay, I mean...
But it's your choice. If it depends how you're feeling.
We gotta kill... We gotta... We gotta kill... Sorry, we gotta kill this out. I'm sure Twitch chat just wants me to kill him anyway. Oh, he is,
pretty tough.
Okay, maybe you're right. Maybe you're right. Maybe I should listen to the developer and not be some troll QA guy just trying to break the game and make everyone feel bad. Yeah, I do have to say, it's a shame about the Apple TV stuttering, because when it's not stuttering, it generally does feel really, really responsive and good.
Well, hopefully we'll see you upstairs.
Yeah, yeah, I'm 100% going upstairs right after this. After I get some lunch. All right.
Yeah, same.
I definitely... Oh, I got to do it, though. This is my mission. Yeah, there we go. All right, portal scrolls create checkpoints. All right, cool. Well, I mean, this is feels great so far. Is there anything else that you think I should get to here?
I mean, there's like 7 levels to the demo, so like,
you barely even looked at my game. What are you talking about?
So, basically we left it as an open-ended demo, so the only thing that's restricting is the battery life, so people can play as long as they want upstairs.
Okay, excellent. Yeah. And are there any plans for any time frame we could talk about right now? Demos or anything?
We're paralleling Path of Exile 2, so obviously, big brother, so we can't really talk about sort of timings of release or anything like that until we're happy with like where that's at, so... So, yeah.
Okay.
Basically, Path of Exile 2 will be first.
Okay.
Yeah.
Excellent. Well, thank you for letting me play, and I had a lot of fun. I'm excited to see where it goes.
Awesome. Thank you.
All right. Well, thank you, everyone, for watching and following along, and I'll be upstairs playing for anyone that's here at ExileCon. Thank you, guys.
Cool. Thanks.